Good day, everyone. Welcome to Keystone English. My name is Key, and I will be your host and instructor for the series. If you're taking the time to watch this video, you've probably watched many, many other lessons on YouTube about pronunciation. They may vary in quality, but generally speaking, most English teachers teach pronunciation in the same way. This listen and repeat method is exactly as it sounds. Listen to an instructor say a word and parrot it back at them. But I'll tell you why this method doesn't work. It requires the listener to have excellent copying skills rather than the instructor have good interpersonal skills. That's why I created the proprioceptive method, a technique that requires students to focus on their own mouths rather than on the teacher's sounds. For each phoneme in the English language, I intend to give you a set of instructions which will allow you to practice on your own. Before we start, a quick reminder. The mouth is composed of four different parts: the lips, the teeth, the tongue, and the breath. In this episode, I will teach you how to make the b and p sounds, both individually and how to pronounce them within words. Since these are a consonant phoneme pair, they share the same mouth formation, meaning the lips, teeth, and tongue are the same for both of them. The only difference is whether they are voiced, with air coming from the neck, or voiceless, with air coming from the chest. Starting with b, close your lips and open them quickly. Do not use your teeth or your tongue. B. Since B is voiced, make sure the air is coming from your neck. If you're having trouble, try saying a few Vietnamese words like ba sham or ban bao. To make sure we're saying it correctly, let's apply the chest bounce test. Cross your arms and place them against your chest. Now, try to say ba, ba, ba. Next, boy, boy, boy. Finally, bye, bye, bye. Congratulations, you've successfully pronounced the ba sound along with the English words boy and bye. That's how you pronounce the b sound at the beginning of words. How about the end? Well, first I'll teach you the soft pronunciation. When saying a word with a b ending, like rob, native English speakers simply close their lips at the end. By closing your lips, you are immediately shutting off the air, effectively cutting off the word. No air means no sound. However, it's important to note that the sound must still be voiced so that when we say words like robber, we can still hear that it's a B sound. Let's try a few practice words. Baby, baby, baby. Baboon, baboon, baboon. Bib, bib, bib. The letter P is very similar in that it requires you to close your lips and open them quickly. Pa. If you want to get technical, linguists call this a bilabial plosive. Bilabial means two lips. Plosive shares the same root word as explosion. Pa. To say this correctly, apply the chest bounce test. First, say the sounds ba, ba, ba. Feel how your arms do not move. Now, try saying the pa, pa, pa sound. If you say it correctly, you'll feel your arms push upward from your chest. Words starting with a P must always pass the chest bounce test. Let's try a few words. Pay, pay, pay. pen, 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 pie, pie, pie. Remember that with each word, you must feel your chest press up against your arms. Pah. That's for a P at the beginning of a word. A P at the end of a word is very similar to a B ending, where you simply close your lips and shut off the air. Let's try a few words. Hop, hop, hop. Tip, tip, tip. Lap, lap, lap. With multi-syllable words, however, the P sound must be slightly stressed. Happy, happy, happy. Typing, typing, typing. Hippopotamus, hippopotamus, hippopotamus. Again, make sure to apply the chest bounce test to make sure you're making the correct voiceless sound. Are you still with me? Because the challenge doesn't end there. There are still words which combine the B and P sounds. For the following, I'm going to use my hand to indicate whether the sound is voiced or voiceless, but you should continue to use the chest bounce test. Ready? Pub, pub, pub. Blip, blip, blip. Pebble, pebble, pebble. Bullpen, bullpen, bullpen. Being able to quickly and accurately change the source of your air is the key to saying the B and P sounds. Some words, if spoken incorrectly, can easily lead to misunderstandings. For example, how many of you own an iPad? When using a door, do you push or do you pull? Can a rapid move rapidly? Despite being the first consonant phoneme pair, B and P are frequently the most difficult phoneme sounds for Vietnamese learners to pick up. But I hope that doesn't discourage anyone from trying. The important thing is to move away from traditional listening techniques and move towards new strategies. That's all for this episode. If you want more updates on our lessons, be sure to like and subscribe below. This is Key signing off from Keystone English. Remember our motto of the day, don't bet with your pets.